Hi, I'm Dr. Lorne Hammond, and we're here in the Fannin Tower in the middle of all the collections that belong to the people of British Columbia here at the Royal British Columbia Museum. And what I'm going to talk about today is just a little bit from our gold collection, which relates to the gold rush. And a lot of people don't know that British Columbia had a mint established in 1861 in the middle of the gold rush. There was no money in the colony in the middle of the gold rush. Money was a great shortage. So they sent to have dyes made in San Francisco, brought it up, and Francis Claudette was the master of the mint in New Westminster, and you could bring your gold in to see him, and he would make you a $10 solid gold coin, or a $20 solid coin, or a solid silver piece. One of the coins is so rare that we only know of one in private hands, and the other one disappeared in an auction in Amsterdam in 1939, just before the start of World War II, and it's never surfaced again. And these are extremely rare coins. Our coin collection is really kind of interesting as well, not just because it's rare, but we have one coin that has a hole drilled in it. And that's because John Robson was the editor of the New Westminster, of the British Columbian newspaper, which was out of New Westminster. And he'd heard about the mint, went to see the mint, the colonial treasurer was boasting about it, and he thought that was pretty interesting, so he brought his own gold, and they made him a $10 coin out of his own gold. They melted it, poured it, made a blank, and then they're stampers that are used to make the coins. And then he drilled a hole in his solid gold coin, and he put it on his watch chain, and wore it for the rest of his life. Our mint, actually, in British Columbia, although it only lasted a year, because it cost more than $20 worth of gold to make a $20 coin, predates the Canadian Federal Mint. It's the oldest mint in Canada, and it was here on the Fraser River.